every lie that I ever told, paid for every heart that I ever stole. I played my cards and I didn't fold. Well, it ain't that hard when you got sold. Somewhere I heard that life is a test. I've been through the worst, but I still give my best. God made my mold different from the rest. Then he broke that mold, so I know I'm blessed. Stand up now and face the sun. Won't hide my tail or turn and run. It's time to do what must be done. Be a king when kingdom comes. Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. Go ahead and tell everybody. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Well, you can tell everybody. Yeah, you can tell everybody. Go ahead and tell everybody. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. Yes, I am, yes, I am, yes, I am. I'm the man, I'm the man, I'm the man. I got all the answers to your questions. I'll be the teacher, you could be the lesson. I'll be the preacher, you be the confession. I'll be the quick relief to all you stressing. It's a thin line between love and hate. Is you really real or is you really fake? I'm a soldier standing on my feet. No surrender and I won't retreat. Stand up now and face the sun. Won't hide my tail or turn it.
Get you right, girl, them boys to the left, like, oh, na-na, look what you done started. Oh, oh, nana. Why you gotta act so naughty? Oh, oh, nana. I'm about to spend all this cash. Oh, oh, nana. If you keep shaking that. Oh, na, na, na.
Put your hands in the air if you're loving tonight.
Oh, na, na, na.
Keep your hands in the air if you're spending the night.
Oh, na, na, na. Oh, na, 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 na.
Everybody say it like.
Oh, na, na, na. Oh, na, 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 na.
Everybody say it.
You the one that's hella bad, yeah. You the one they never had, yeah. Oh, yeah. All the problems you done had, yeah. Lead them broke fellas in the past, yeah. Oh, yeah. Girl, you had good, but I could give you better. I'll have you thinking about forever. I'm like, say, oh, nah, nah. Look what you done started.
Look what you done started.
Oh, nah,
nah. Oh, nah, nah.
Why you gotta act so naughty?
Acting a fool.
Oh, nah, nah. Hey, about to spend all this cash. Oh, nah, nah.
Put your hands in the air if you're loving
tonight. If you're loving tonight. Oh, na, na, na.
Keep your hands in the air if you're spending the night.
Oh, na, na, na. Oh, na, 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 na.
Everybody say it like.
Oh, na, na, na.
Na, na,
oh, na, 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 na.
Everybody say
it. I'm feeling lucky tonight.
Everybody say
it. When we leave this party, you gon' love me tonight.
Everybody say it.
Lucky night,
girl.
When we leave this party, you gon' love me tonight. Oh, na, na, na.
Put your hands in the air if you're loving tonight.
Oh, na, na, na.
Keep your hands in the air if you're spending the night.
Oh, na, na, na. Oh, na, 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 na.
Everybody say it like.
Oh, na, na, na. Oh, na, 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 na.
Everybody say
it.
I'm so fresh, man. Y'all scared to do it how I do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your public address announcer, Ed Bishop. Welcome this evening to the University of Missouri, Kansas City's Durwood Field. Tonight, the Blues welcome to Kansas City the Chicago Red Stars. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the referees and players onto Verizon Wireless Field. The Walk of Champions is brought to you by RG Federal Credit Union. Here are the starters for the visiting Chicago Red Stars. Goalkeeper number one, Karina LeBlanc. Defender number three, Keisha Morway. Midfielder number eight, Julie Johnston. Forward number nine, Melissa Tancredi. Defender number 11, Rachel Kwan. Defender number 13, Michelle Winino. Midfielder number 15, Emily Van Egmond. Midfielder number 17, Lori Kolupny. Forward number 19, Adriana Leon. Forward number 23, Kristen Press. And midfielder number 38, Julianne Sitch. Ladies and gentlemen, these are the Chicago Red Stars. And now, ladies and gentlemen, stand up and let me hear you as we introduce the starting 11 for FC Kansas City. With 61 caps from the U.S. Women's National Team, the 2013 NWSL Defender of the Year, number four, Becky Sauerbrunn. From Notre Dame, number six, midfielder, Jackie. From UCLA, number seven, midfielder Jenna Richmond. With 111 caps from the U.S. Women's National Team, number eight forward, Amy Rodriguez. From Merritt Mathias. With 102 caps and 22 goals from the U.S. Women's National Team, the 2013 Golden Boot Award winner and last season's NWSL MVP, number 12 forward, Lauren Holiday. With two caps for the U.S. Women's National Team from the University of San Diego, number 13, defender Leanne Robinson. From Florida State University, number 14, defender Cassie Coleman. With three caps from the U.S. Women's National Team, the 2013 NWSL Rookie of the Year, number 15, midfielder Erica Timrak. With 56 caps for the U.S. Women's National Team, the 2013 NWSL Goalkeeper of the Year, number 18, Nicole Barnhart. And with six caps for the Polish Women's National Team, number 23, defender Nikki Phillips. The head coach of FC Kansas City is Vladko Andonovsky. His assistant coaches are Hugh Williams and Goran Karadzov. Goalkeeper coach is Kelly Miller. And the head athletic trainer is Sean Dumares. Ladies and gentlemen, FC Kansas City. Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd please remain standing and direct your attention to the center of the field, please join us as the Blue Springs High School JROTC present our colors. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the playing of our national anthem. Johnson as Enrico Palazzo.
Then we have Paul Boyd.
Oh, God.
Here, have some sugar. Have some sugar. Oh.
He's pretty good. Please direct your attention to midfield for tonight's coin toss. Referee Christina Uncle, assistant referees Amanda Ross and Jordan Pramick, along with fourth official Nikola Alexic, are joined by Red Stars captain Lori Kolupny and FC Kansas City captain Becky Sauerbrunn, and our Firestone honorary captain is Stephanie Weber from Henson's Heroes.
Pardon me, Tancredi. Melissa is a Canadian who just finished up classes this week at Logan College of Chiropractics over in St. Louis. She had a big tweet about it. Her last day of class was on the 18th. And just delighted about the fact that in 9 weeks she would officially be a doctor of chiropractic. Dr. Melissa Palma Julie Tancredi. And she is a very physical player. One of the players that just kind of throws their body around, no regard for the body. And we'll keep an eye on her tonight. And Kristen Press, a forward, we saw her with the U.S. national team in the two friendlies against France. And Press's legs might be a little bit wobbly as well. Becky Sauerbrunn can relate to that, as can Lauren Holiday. Let's go down to the sideline. Molly Dreska is part of our broadcast team tonight. Molly?
Thanks, Dave. We just talked to the coaches, and they told us a little bit more about Sarah Hagen. She just got here from Germany, like Dave said earlier, and she's been added to the roster, but she can't play in a game yet until it gets cleared with her former club, Bayern Munich.
Thank you, Molly. And they went through kind of the same thing a week ago with Katrina Gorey, who came from Australia, and there's all sorts of paperwork. And Dom, was it seamless for you when you came to the United States in Major League Soccer? Were there some issues initially to make sure all the papers are filed and everything's good to go?
Yeah, I think the most difficult bit was coming to get to college, play out here, play college. But the professional transition was pretty simple. You know, it wasn't any paperwork. It was just straight from college to pro, so it was a good one.
Well, you need to write a book and tell us how you ended up going from England to a junior college in Texas.
Seriously, I do.
Yeah. National Junior College Player of the Year. And by the way, Dom Dwyer was Major League Soccer's Player of the Month in May. Nobody has scored more goals in MLS this year to date than you with 11. It's been a great jump up for you.
It's been okay. It's been a fun season so far.
FC Kansas City wearing their blue tops here tonight. Chicago is in the white. Again, they did play here back on April the 30th. Lauren Holiday will handle all the corner kicks and this free kick, sending it into the box, headed back out by Chicago. Julianne Sitch there defensively for the Red Stars. And Rachel Kwan on the throw-in. Chicago able to benefit from a bit of a break in the schedule earlier when they had that 5-game win streak. The competition has been stiffer, but not able to score on Wednesday against Western New York. Ball taken away from Merritt Mathias. Stan Robinson is there. Robinson, one of the vocal leaders on this FC Kansas City team, and she said it was really no different having the national team players away. She'd make a bunch of noise anyway, but as far as organizing things, Leanne was there doing that. There's Kristen Press through traffic, able to get by Nikki Phillips, and she can't keep it from going out of play. But that's one of the players. Boy, Don, we're going to keep a close watch on her tonight.
Absolutely. She looks very sharp, you know, quick turn of pace, and a very dangerous player.
Press had an assist in that first friendly against France, assisting to Sydney LaRue.
To your right, Kristen, to your right.
In a country right now obsessed with soccer, you don't have to like soccer to watch the World Cup right now.
No, you don't.
Nicole Barnhart back with FC Kansas City after 2 weeks training with the women's national team. Not able to get on the field. Sarah Keene, a rookie for FC Kansas City, did a great job in the victory down in Houston. In fact, the confidence that has translated to the practice field this week has been incredible. Some of the stops that she has made. Leon was tangled up briefly there with Merritt Mathias. Jen Buskowski will play it back to Nikki Phillips. Cassie Coleman back in her normal spot. That's Erica Timrek. Now Holiday will play it back to Coleman. They give and go. Ball will roll through. Rachel Kwan, the throw in. Well, Don, when we look at what's happened with FC Kansas City this year, the fact that they're undefeated, 7-0-3 when scoring first, why is that so important? I mean, you look at all the teams in the league, you always want to score first, but for this team, it's been such a big thing for them to get that first goal.
Absolutely, and, you know, I think possession has a very big part to do with it. You know, it's hot and humid out there today, and, you know, it's very important for them to keep hold of the ball and wear Chicago out. And, you know, if they can just keep hold of the ball and get themselves a goal or two, then, you know, Chicago will have to open up and press, and, you know, hopefully it'll be a very simple and straightforward game for them.
Chicago on a bit of a road trip here, game 2 of 3. Some travel issues for them on Friday. We don't know. The ball will slide through to Karina LeBlanc. Headed Leanne Robinson, Nikki Phillips, and Erica Timrak, who set up the game-winning goal at Houston in stoppage time to Fran Silva with seconds to play in regulation to give FCKC that one-goal victory and 3 points on the road with the national team players away. Timrak, last year's rookie of the year in the NWSL, playing it back to Jenna Richmond, who had her first goal at Houston. First goal as a professional. She was on the national championship team last year at UCLA. Lauren Holiday slide it through to Rodriguez. A lot of good conversation. Winterno is there. Kolupny, the captain, sends it to Tancredi. And Nicole Barnhart is there. Melissa Tancredi, 32 years old, two-time Olympian, getting a bronze for the Canadians back in 2012. Great locker room presence, very physical player. And a target that FCKC is aware of tonight. Erica Timrak has space in the middle on a run. Slide it through to Rodriguez.
Great, great positive play from Timrak right there. Attacking, she just got to drive at that defense today. You know, keep backing up, and A-Rod can make runs and find some space, and she'll get a few chances.
Timrak very hard on herself about decision-making and passing, and I think some of the better players are often like that. They're their toughest critic, always looking for a way to get better.
Absolutely, she's a hungry girl, and she's definitely desperate to get back in that national team. I got two in
here. Just be corner kick, Lauren Holiday. Short, near post. Rodriguez was there, and this has not been one of the strengths of FC Kansas City. They don't necessarily have a good target. I'll try to create chaos in the six-yard box. Now, Sarah Hagen is a bigger player. She'll make a difference when she is available. Holiday, second corner attempt. Again, short on a hop. Coleman not able to get there. Now cleared out by Chicago. Headed forward, Jenna Richmond. Leon had it momentarily. Plays it back. Leon again. Polupny. Now for FC Kansas City, Buskowski. Timrak. Amy Rodriguez, second in the league in scoring with 9 goals. Didn't play last year after a pregnancy and a baby. And Shannon Box, one of the players for Chicago. You see defensively 1-0 there for the Red Stars. Shannon Box back training with the national team over the last couple of weeks. Boy, approaching 200 caps for the Americans. You would suspect at some point she'd be available for Chicago. One of the great modern day names, all-time names for U.S. soccer. Common goes down and a foul called. We're in the 8th minute at Durwood Stadium with Dom Dwyer from Sporting Kansas City. I'm Dave Stewart. You're a big soccer fan in terms of coming out and watching the women. LeBlanc was there to punch it. Now the ball knocked back by 1-0. And Chicago's Leon keeps it in play. Richmond not able to get there for FCKC. Slide tackle by Buskowski. Lauren Holiday plays it to Tim Rack, who will be facing the sun as she looks toward the goal. Rack lets it rip. Tackle by Buskowski. They play on. Wide, Leanne Robinson. And Cassie Coleman will watch it roll through the touchline. How do you see the matchup so far? Any advantage to either team in style?
Yeah, fantastic pressure from Kansas City right now in the midfield, you know, giving Chicago no time on the ball.
Robinson outside of the 18, lets it rip and over the top.
Yeah, the Chicago fans just backing away, giving her space.
Go back to Lauren Holiday and her attempt. She was the most valuable player in the inaugural year of the NWSL, and an absolute bomb from beyond the 18.
Very, very positive start from Kansas City. You know, definitely controlling the game, and you know, they'll start tiring out the Chicago team if they can keep hold of the ball.
It's amazing, you know, they can do all this with GPS now, and they are able to calculate time going forward, how many miles you put on over the course of a game. In the first friendly, U.S. against France, Holiday had 1 more mile than the second closest American, which means she's constantly moving.
Absolutely, and it's unbelievable. And you know, she's not just moving. You know, if you watch her closely and hear her, she's communicating with the players around her. You know, she's making sure everyone's in the right position. And you know, what makes her a leader and such a valuable player.
Well, watching the team in training, they follow her lead. There's no question. Michelle 1-0. Pressure from Matthias. Plays it to Keisha Morway. So when you've got a veteran like Holiday, it's hard to believe sometimes when you think that she's just 26, but okay, here's a national team player with 100 caps. You wear that captain's armband. Does that get the full attention of everybody around the locker room, on the practice field, the way they go to meetings, just everything that it takes to be a pro?
Absolutely. I mean, yeah, I think the thing about her is I think she'd be a leader whether she had an armband or not. You know, she's a character, and she's a, you know, a fantastic player, and she's a presence, and you know, you can tell by the way people play against her, they respect her and, you know, sometimes fearful of her.
Ian Robinson weighing her options and plays it back to Becky Sauerbrunn. You would anticipate Sauerbrunn and Holiday both playing entire first halves and see the game situation they play on after the contact. Rodriguez has her pat taken away. Rachel Kwan sticking her foot in there. Back to Holiday, who everybody still calls Cheney. She's always going to be Cheney. She made a name as Cheney. Plays it wide, Leanne Robinson. Morway was able to sneak in between player and line. LeBlanc in her absence. Taylor Vansell started for the Red Stars in goal in that loss to Western New York. Crazy game. Give up a goal in the first minute and the last minute. You think 2-0, well, that's not close. It was close.
Yeah.
The 88 minutes in between. Long taking her time. A 3-year starter at the University of Nebraska, which is not all that far from here. Sauerbrunn heading it through the touchline. And a throw in for Adriana Leon. Kristen Press. Kolupny in the middle, headed over top.
Good defensive play there from Kansas City. You know, again, getting numbers behind the ball. Just two players challenging in the air for that one. You know, great commitment from those players and desire to keep a clean sheet.
Kolupny's been such a leader for this Chicago team. Tim Rack through traffic. Jenna Richmond getting her first pro goal in her 14th game. Somebody the team stole in the second round of the draft this year. Came off the bench early and has been a starter ever since.
Looking like a great player. You know, she's improving every game and you know, looking confident and very sharp today. Her and Holiday doing a fantastic job in the middle right now.
Holiday, pressure from behind. Van Egmond. Now Cassie Coleman, a left back, coming all the way forward in the box. Coleman is there and a sliding stop by Karina LeBlanc to smother it. LeBlanc played in that 2-1 Germany win against Canada this week. And what great value when your left back, right back can go end to end like that. Tim Rack, middle A-Rod. Pressure behind Richmond. Ball will roll through as Keisha Morway escorts it out. Throw in FC Kansas City, Leanne Robinson. Scoreless in the 15th minute on a hot night in Kansas City. FCKC with back-to-back Saturday games here at home. Portland is next week. It's Jen Buskowski.
Kansas City looking very sharp these opening 15 minutes. Moving the ball very well.
Now fatigue is way different now, not playing twice a week. A-Rod chases it down. Sitting it all the way across. Tim Rack will run it down outside.
Emily Sashev, she's two!
Holiday plays it back and goal kick Chicago. It's 2-3 here tonight. FC Kansas City second in the NWSL. The Red Stars are behind them, 4 points back.
Be a huge 3 points tonight if Kansas City can get the job done. Definitely in need of these 3 points, you know. Pick them away from Chicago and, you know, make them catch up to Seattle at the top.
The rain still cruising. 10 wins, 2 draws, 32 points, an 8-point lead over the second place team.
Looking like a good team. Tough one to beat, obviously. Impossible right now.
Yeah. They've been the class of the league so far. Of course, the top four make the postseason. And these two we watch here tonight would appear to be in pretty good place.
Absolutely. Like I said, you know, 3 points tonight will keep them in very good standings to make playoffs.
Pressure in the back, Richmond. Sending it forward just a bit too tall for Van Egmond. Now Holiday switches the field. Coleman will run it down. Tim Rack setting up the game-winning goal at Houston to Fran Silva at the end of stoppage time. And the momentum swing there at the end of the match after Silva scored, she immediately ran to the ref and said, how much time is left? Because you better to be just seconds. And literally, as soon as that ball was back in play, the whistle sounded.
Absolutely. It was a huge, huge goal. And, you know, I think definitely deserved. You know, the girls played great. And, you know, I could see by the video. I watched it online at home. And they were absolutely delighted. So it was great to see and definitely deserved.
Made it a good flight home, no question.
I bet.
FC Kansas City 7-4-3. They recall the start of the year with a different formation because last year they were so good possession but not finishing. And they decided to go back to what was comfortable with a 4-2-3-1. And Sarah Hagen is up to speed and they're able to evaluate her fit again. They could change it again, go with two players up top. That's a normal spot for her.
It's absolutely a huge benefit, you know, having two fantastic forwards and, you know, also having wingers like Tim Rack. And, you know, she's had a little bit of national team experience. And, you know, Kansas City definitely need to get her on the ball. You know, she'll make things happen and drive at the defense.
Block outside of the 18. Distributes to the right. Now Van Egmond. Emily from Stanford. A lot of Pacific Coast players. Stanford, USC, UCLA, North Carolina has a load of players in the NWSL. Kolupny. And a goal kick, FC Kansas City. Interesting, though, you look at some of the goalkeepers that are 30-plus. LeBlanc is 34, and Barnhart is not quite that old, but goalkeepers tend to learn how to manage their body. They learn the game. They can play to 30 plus.
Absolutely. I mean, they just stand around in the goal, so they're lazy. it's different goalkeepers. You know, obviously it's tough wear and tear on their body, but it's definitely, you know, a different aspect. And they, you know, as long as they can keep their movement sharp and their flexibility there, then, you know, they can last quite a few years.
Matthias at the edge of the 18. Chicago's there defensively. Double team. Van Egmond, Leanne Robinson will settle. Jen Biskowski. Back to Robinson, swishing the field. Cassie Coleman. And hustles to keep it play.
Kansas City needs to keep opening up the field, keep switching the play. They'll open up that defense.
Tim Rack. Holiday. Tim Rack's attempt was blocked and out of play. Throw in FCKC. Cassie Coleman will handle it.
Very, very hot to be playing on that turf. Heat's definitely going to be a factor later on in the game.
Now you can see maybe a third of the field is in shade. No more than that. Still upper 80s here in Kansas City.
Nice and cool in this room, though.
It is cool in this room. Is this the first official day of summer?
I think it is.
I believe it is.
Yeah. There's a pool party, yeah. CJ's looking so cool and fresh right now. and Dom. That's Dom Dwyer right next to him, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. He wants to be Dom Dwyer.
Oh, I can't wait to tell him that later.
It's only one. Of course, you were the Major League Soccer Player of May with 6 goals. Any common thread through all that for you?
What do you mean?
Are they similar in style, or you have 6 different types of goals?
They're actually pretty different. You know, I had a couple of PKs, but I definitely scored some different goals this year. And, you know, I came off the bench the other game and scored one. That was probably my favorite. It kind of hurt, but it was pretty cool.
It hurt?
Yeah, it hurt. As I was coming through to hit it, some guy absolutely crushed me. But I think it wouldn't have gone in, then I might have
hurt worse.
Yeah, I've been on my knees crying.
How glad to have you in the broadcast booth with us. You might as well be up at the booth because you would be here anyway.
Absolutely, I'll be there anyway, just causing more mischief down there.
And you saw Kai Kamara get married last night.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun. He's probably here today, actually, maybe, if he's awake.
Foul in the middle of the field, Tim Rack going down. Buskowski will have to wait. Kai is in the offseason, right?
Yeah, Kai's in the off-season right now, you know, enjoying his time in England. He's been you know, had a tough season at Middlesbrough and been in and out of the lineup. You know, I think he's definitely looking forward to this next season coming.
Tyus takes it from Van Egmond. That's a rip. Over top. Goal kick Chicago. Barrett Mathias, one of the players with great fitness and work ethic.
Guys, it's okay.
Absolutely, it's going to be vital today for Kansas City. You know, having good pressure as soon as the ball turns over, getting the ball back nice and quick, and keeping possession and keeping Chicago moving from left to right.
How much do you try to hydrate pregame on a day like this?
Oh, so much. You're normally a bit bloated in the warm-up, and you know, you need to drink right before you come out for the warm-ups and then try not to drink too much in the warm-up and you should be good by game time, but sometimes it's almost impossible.
Maybe Melissa Tancredi. Tancredi playing in her fourth game with the Red Stars. Her first start, played at Notre Dame. Try to walk it off.
Tough tackle there. Think she'll be okay. Maybe a little knee-to-knee dead leg. Those ones are painful.
Come on, Tree, back in.
Kind of plays to her style, but it's better to deliver the blow, I suppose.
I'd say so.
It's Tim Racken. Quan tied up. On the boundary, throwing Van Egmond.
Kansas City not letting up pressure. As soon as Chicago get the ball, they need to keep pressing them.
Might have been the thing that really stood out with Seattle, for example, the pressure that they would apply in the midfield and a lot of the passes being off because the pressure was so intense.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, they come out sharp and, you know, the other team don't get comfortable on the ball and Kansas City keep a hold of the game and Chicago are too tired when they get the ball.
Robinson plays it back to Becky Sauerbrunn. There's an interesting blog at fckansascity.com about, you know, what's it like to play for your national team. And her point was, you know, we all kind of feel that, even as a fan, you're vested in that team.
Absolutely, it's amazing. I was down at Power and Light for the men's game the other day, and it was. You know, the country's coming together, and you know, I think that is in women's and men's.
She had Mathias.
It's a great, great movement from Mathias there. Couldn't quite get online with Holiday.
But Sauerbrunn's point was, you know, it's a chance to be a part of something bigger than yourself, whether you're a player or just a spectator. But the Cup, some of the Cahill goal to me so far, it has been the best one.
Oh my, that was a fantastic goal. You know, there's been some fantastic goals this World Cup, and you know, the standard's been very good, and obviously a few upsets and a few teams who are, you know, just teams who are expected to win, and really they just come up against teams who are underestimated.
What do you think it does for the NWSL, the women? They have their World Cup in a year. For Major League Soccer in Kansas City specifically, you've got Matt Beisler as starter, you've got Graham Zusi who comes in and assists on the game-winning goal off of his corner kick, but to get exposure to a team and a league on a global basis, what does it do?
It's amazing. You know, obviously it's huge for the city, and it's, you know, this is a Kansas City is a soccer city, and I think they're proving that each week, and you know, attendances are rising, you know, there's more attention. Zusi, you know, he should be in the starting lineup next game. You know, came on last game and put a fantastic corner in, so it'll be very cool to have two Kansas City guys in the starting lineup.
Well, and you've got Jimmy Fallon on the Tonight Show
yeah,
talking about
that.
Our guys. You know, he should
great.
Be on the cover of a magazine. Well, maybe he will be.
Yeah, Zusi's been on a few. I've seen a few of his shirt off, and he's, you know, marketing himself well, and it's fantastic to see. It's nice to see such a nice, humble guy still as well. You know, he's the exact same whether he's playing week in, week out, or not playing at all.
Richmond pulls it back out. 27th minute now, we're scoreless. Chicago Red Stars, FC Kansas City, second and third place teams in the NWSL. Erica Timrak outside of the 18, sending it far post. Can't find Mathias.
Great play from Timrak there, getting to the end line, whipping the ball across the box. Mathias unable to connect. You see Tim Rack right here, great left-footed ball across the box. Flash just can't quite get there, it's just a step late. Good play from Kansas City.
Yeah, Tim Rack shielding her eyes as she's looking this direction. Directly into the sun at this point. Lori Kolupny has space across the middle of the field, circles back. Setting it through, not able to get it to Tancredi. Thias, middle, Jenna Richmond. Laskowski, pressure from behind. Kristen Press. Tim Rack and the ball. Kicked by Winino. You can hear from the microphones on the field all of the communication. Rodriguez tries to keep it. Now Holiday, Mathias. Headed. Tim Rack and A-Rod wide to the left.
Great strike from A-Rod there, trying to get a foot around it. It's good play from Kansas City, good pressure right now.
Well, the beauty of the Cahill goal in the World Cup was just the one-time beauty. Just killing it out of the air.
Kind of like that?
Yeah.
Just trying to whip her foot around it. Can't quite get all the way around it, but great try from Rodriguez there. Looking sharp.
Yeah, to be able to hit the ball. I mean, if you're off by half an inch, it's not going to go where you want it to, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. And, you know, it's on a favored left foot. You know, she'll want to do better with that, but it's a very difficult attempt there, and it was a good try from Rodriguez there.
Kristen Press.
Great tackle.
Taken away. Laskowski to Lauren Holiday.
Nice bit of skill there from Holiday. Sensing there's only a few players up, just keeping the ball, being patient, very smart play.
Coleman. Tim Rack fills behind her. On another run. Had A-Rod in front. They don't connect. Kicked out. Throw in FCKC.
Kansas City knocking on the door of that goal. They want to keep this possession and hopefully get a goal out of it right now. Next 5 minutes, very crucial for Kansas City.
7-0-3 when scoring first. Tim Rack back to Coleman. And a giveaway. CFC Kansas City girls had a movie night at the strength and conditioning coach's house. They watched Brave, which I haven't seen.
I have seen it. It's very good.
Yeah?
Yeah. And it was by choice as well.
Okay. Not somebody else's choice, your own?
Okay. No, it was my choice. It was my choice.
A-Rod spinning.
Yeah, and I knew they had their movie night because I invited them all to my game and they didn't want to come. Hmm.
More than 15,000 for the U.S. Open Cup match this week at Sporting Park, which is pretty remarkable. I mean, it's full every time, but it's not Major League Soccer league play and still 15,000 plus.
Yeah, unbelievable. I remember in the Open Cup about 2 years ago, my first game actually, that was, you know, maybe about 6,000 or 7,000, you know, so it's over double that now, and it's unbelievable. I mean, you see the city changing, and, you know, the attendances at this game, you know, they're starting to support FC Kansas City and Sporting Kansas City.
Well, obviously, the players on each support the other. On the two-week break that FC Kansas City had when they were ordered by the coach not to think about soccer for a couple of days, so, of course, they all went to the Sporting game that night.
It's funny. Soccer's your life, and... You know, obviously the coach just wants them to relax and try and rest their minds mentally. I think that's one of the biggest parts of the game. You know, just trying to be relaxed, and, you know, it's physical and mental battles which you have to deal with each day.
Lorway played it back to the keeper, Karina LeBlanc. Leanne Sitch. And Nikki Phillips to Merritt Mathias. Sidestepping around Leon. Robinson with space. Lauren Holiday.
Come on, get it back.
Just wonder with Holiday over 100 caps, World Cup in a year, if she has a timetable, how long to play.
Well, I'm sure she'll want to keep playing and be a part of that.
Yeah.
Up, come on.
Such a big part of the women's national team. Becky Sauerbrunn with trouble with Kolupny in back. Now Richmond. Holiday, Buskowski.
Holiday's doing a great job just finding those soft spots. Getting the ball wide to Timrak, driving at the defense.
Timrak on a run, left-footed shot at the edge of the 18. Not a problem for LeBlanc.
Yeah, it's good positive play from Kansas City there, you know. Timrak again, driving at the defense, trying to get a shot off on a weaker left foot. You know, can't quite get the power she wanted. It wasn't quite the strike, but it's good positive play, and they need to keep shooting and keep getting shots on goal.
Robinson will throw it in right in front of the FCKC bench. Fias. And the ball will be flipped out by Winino. Holiday, not the numbers that she put up last year, but still having a heavy influence on this team.
Good. Tank on an angle, backing in a little, Tank. Injury.
FCKC making a move as they played so well over the past six matches, winning the last four after back-to-back draws. Richmond wide, Leon Robinson. And collegiately in San Diego, flips it in the middle. And A-Rod up top. Oh, good swing that time by Timrak. LeBlanc had to go down and get that corner kick, Kansas City, the third for Lauren Holiday.
Great reactions there from Timrak. Fantastic first touch. I think goalkeeper might have made a great save. I think she might hit the post. Timrak, good first touch, instinctive strike. I think it hits the post and hits the goalkeeper and is out for a corner.
Third corner kick for Lauren Holiday. Rodriguez is inside of the six, along with Merritt Mathias. Play it short on a hop. A-Rod trying to block for Nikki Phillips, who has scored a goal this year. Watch him in training. Defenders can score. And you figure at one point they played up top anyway. They were a forward.
Absolutely. I feel like everyone's a forward at one point.
Yeah.
You can kick it hard and high, you can be a forward.
Somebody had to convince them that there'd be great value and rewards playing in back?
Someone's got to defend.
Your coach at Sporting was quite a defender for the national team and for the Wizards as well.
He was. He's he often joins in at training and a few possession drills and stuff like that, and he's definitely obviously, you know, he's very competitive, but he's definitely, he still loves playing, and, it's fun to get him tired and running around because he's not quite as fit as he used to be, but I think he still wants to play like that way.
Years after retirement, I saw him play futsal in a men's league as if it was the World Cup final.
That's how he treats everything. Every training session is intense, and, he doesn't let up, and he demands that from his players every training session, and there's no days off. If you're in a training, then you're working, and when you step between those white lines, it's all business.
Well, Peter Vermes recognized on Friday as one of the Coach of the Year finalists for the Kevin Gray Soccer Awards. Vladko Andonovsky of FC Kansas City joining Tony Toko from Rockhurst University, which is very close to UMKC. Toko with over 600 wins in the NAIA Hall of Fame. And Peter able to get Cup championships as a player and coach, same team. Holiday on a run in the middle. As Mathias left, A-Rod tries to play it. One time and get out of the air. Still a Chicago player on the ground in the box. Timrak weaving, her attempt is blocked. And Robinson will kick it out as maybe Keisha Moreway getting attention now. Sometimes, you know, what happens into the box, it can be friendly fire. It's such a tight space, and you never know who's going to hit you, but it's going to get nasty in there.
Here's a play from Matthias again. Trying to volley it with her left. I think she just catches a player there. Yeah, just a little leg collision. Nothing there bad, just accidental. She should be okay to carry on.
Chicago will play it back to FCKC after the Blues kicked it out. Norway moving fine on the field now. 38th minute, scoreless here. First half, FC Kansas City and Chicago teams 2-3 in the NWSL. Everybody chasing Seattle, 10-0-2. Rain winning again midweek. Holiday wanted Rodriguez, slow to react.
Rodriguez and Holiday always trying to find each other. Really good connection between those two. Not quite clicking just yet.
Kolupny plays it back, win and 0. Now to the keeper. LeBlanc, 3 shutouts this season. 5 for Barnhart. Barnhart's been bored here tonight. It's not a bad problem to have. It's not a lot of action for your goalkeeper.
Absolutely, it's a tough thing about being a goalie. You know, you got to be aware the whole 90 minutes. You never know, there might be one time you're called upon the whole game, so you got to be ready the whole time and concentrating.
Now you're able to get backup keeper some good minutes. The U.S. Open Cup match the other night?
Absolutely.
Because you can't have just one.
You can't. I think we're proving that this season. We've got so many injuries, and you know, luckily we've got a very deep squad, and obviously we're losing guys in the national team too. So, you know, it's a cool problem to have if you have too many players.
Sauerbrunn connecting with Tim Rack, has Coleman wide, plays it that way. Sarah Keane did a terrific job at Houston, going head-to-head against the backup for FCKC from last year. Partly financial decision on allowing Bianca to go. And Keane with a good performance that breeded a lot of confidence. You can practice all you want, but until you go out there and do it in a game, you never really know, do you?
Absolutely. It's, you know, it's a different, you can get your sharpness from training and stuff, but you just need games, and that's the only time you get real experience and can improve as a player.
Kolupny to Morway. Keisha appears to be fine after that collision with Matthias in the box a moment ago. Nicole Barnhart leads the league with her 5 shutouts, 1.2 goals against. Over 5 minutes left in regulation. Could have a couple of minutes of stoppage time added to that. Good crowd here tonight. Expected to be around 2,000.
Very good crowd, very hot crowd as well.
Matthias again plays her way up from right mid. Pressure by Morway. Tancredi comes out of there with it. Skowski tries to pull her down from behind. Matthias goes down and a foul on Keisha Morway.
Yeah, very good smart play from Matthias there. Kansas City under a bit of pressure. Good break in play. She just put her body in the way. Defender just knocking her over there.
Kind of the style that Chicago likes to play. They maybe get in your head a little bit. It's a physical team, scrappy bunch. 4 yellow cards against Western New York last time out. Holiday to Rodriguez, Tim Rack, and LeBlanc.
Kansas City just needs to keep the ball, be very patient. You know, it's going to come. They're not going to be able to go right to goal every time. They need to keep switching the play, open up Chicago a little bit and bring them out. You know, they're controlling the game, but, you know, need to make some more dangerous chances in the next 5 minutes.
6-1, the shots advantage for FC Kansas City over the Red Stars. And Freddie settles. Goes down. Mathias is there. Quickly, FCKC throw in and kicked out by Michelle Winneno. Played in Chicago back in 2009. Germany after that. Once part of the Big 12 conference. Some kind of a
leave it for Carino.
A bad bit of skill there. A bit different.
Might have seen that at soccer camp last week.
Yeah, absolutely. I walked past the street the other day and there was some guy doing it on the corner.
Well, this is soccer camp season, isn't it? The tryouts are done, then camps come after that.
Yeah, we had tryouts today, actually. Open tryouts for Sporting KC. So hopefully maybe I've found some new teammates there. We'll see.
Now the many opt for the academy way where they don't play for their local high school.
Yeah, we got some academy products. Eric Palmer Brown, 17 years old. Fantastic player, he's got a very big future in the game.
Yeah, forced into duty. You don't often see that. I guess Freddie Adu, you could probably think of a couple of teenagers that played in the league at that age, but it's asking a lot, isn't it?
Absolutely, but I think he's responded very well. You know, had a very tough debut. He got a red card and gave away a PK. You know, it's easy to get your head down after that, and he was benched next game, and then center back's injured 5 minutes into the game, and he comes on away from home and does a fantastic job. You know, a very good game, and then for a 17-year-old to have that maturity to, you know, gain the confidence back is unbelievable, and he's got a very bright future in the game.
44th minute, still looking for a goal here between FC Kansas City and rival Chicago, playing for the second time this season here at Durwood Stadium. Becky Sauerbrunn getting in the way for Richmond and Tim Rack.
Kansas City would love a goal right now, right before halftime.
Laskowski goes down with Sitch. And a run in the middle. Come for Tancredi. Barnhart. And again on a bounce, Nicole Barnhart.
Fantastic play from Barnhart there. Two big, big saves.
The beauty of goalkeeping, you're standing around with nothing to do for 20 minutes, then you better be ready for the bullets.
Absolutely, like we said, she was ready. You know, two great saves, one on one, and then obviously from a strike from distance. Fantastic play there.
Now I'm starting to see some grabbing.
Cassie, be ready to go. Cassie, up.
Holiday will take this free kick near the end of regulation. Mathias flipping it to Leanne Robinson. As A-Rod in the middle on the ground and kicked through the touchline. Chicago defensively was there. White jerseys everywhere, adding just 1 minute of stoppage time here. On a bounce to Holiday, back to Robinson. On the ground, Jenna Richmond. And Karina LeBlanc is there again.
Great strike from Richmond there. Very good ball across. She just hits it straight at the goalkeeper. A tough one to get, but you know, she's done very well to get it on target.
Well, Chicago's gonna feel pretty good about going to the locker room in a scoreless tie, aren't they? Considering the possession and the domination.
Absolutely, you know, Kansas City have, I think they've tied Chicago down, and you know, I think it may show in the second half. You know, it's been a very, very confident and solid start from Kansas City, and you know, also good play from Chicago and keeping it at 0-0 right now.
And there's the whistle that will take us to halftime. We have played 45 and still looking for a goal.
his idea. Yeah. Well, hey, let's turn that thing around so we can see the
next time flip around the trigger, please.
Yeah. Except no one will get it.
No.
Visit NWSLsoccer.com for all of your updated league information, team standings, and more. That's NWSLsoccer.com. NWSLsoccer.com provides fans with the latest news, scores, and information on all your favorite players and clubs. Make sure you visit them at NWSLsoccer.com today. Verizon introduces the More Everything plan. Now get even more, two times as much for the same low price on select plans. One of the 13 Verizon stores in the Kansas City area to get signed up today. Research Medical Center is proud to be selected as FC Kansas City's exclusive medical provider. Our team of sports and wellness specialists is ready for any of your healthcare needs, from prevention to injury care. We're here to keep you healthy and active. Paul Mitchell, the school, is the official hair salon of FC Kansas City. Get your hair cut and styled where the blues do at Paul Mitchell, the school, at 95th and Antioch in Overland Park.
Where'd you get the airheads?
Soccer Fit Academy, located at the Overland Park Soccer Complex, is the official training partner of FC Kansas City. Scott Moody and his team at Soccer Fit Academy build specially designed programs for soccer players to enhance their fitness and performance. Tide Dry Cleaners are the official dry cleaners of FC Kansas City. The same Tide you've trusted your clothes with for 65 years now has professional dry cleaning services. Tide's Green Earth technology leaves your clothes fresh and smelling like Tide. Tide Dry Cleaners, we're changing dry. Dr. Neil Kelly, DDS, is pleased to offer his patients convenient, comprehensive dental care. A highly trained and skilled dentist, he is the official dentist of FC Kansas City. Call him at 816-942-8550. And now let's head down to the field where Mix 93.3 Steve Serrano has an exciting contest from our friends at Hendrick Buick GMC Cadillac. Steve.
Alrighty, thank you, Ed. And now let's make some noise for Chad for helping us out right here from Kearney. Now we're going to have some fun. All thanks to our friends at Hendrick Buick GMC and Cadillac just off 103rd and State Line. Chad, what you've got an opportunity right now to win a lease on a 2014 Buick GMC. Now, if we can get Calvin to move out of the way. So are you ready for this?
I'm ready. I'm ready to go.
Got to move it back. We measure this every single time. Yeah, we'll spray it down. All right, make some noise again one more time for Chad. Gonna do this lefty here, Chad. Come on. Just get some support from his wife right there. Do not embarrass her, she says. Oh, that's all right. Let's hear it one more time for Chad. And big thanks again to Hendrick Buick GMC and Cadillac just off 103rd and State Line. But we're still gonna hook you up with an Excite tablet from Toshiba Business Solutions. Ed, back up to you. We'll try to get that back from Calvin.
All right. Thank you, Steve. Thermal King sells America's number one insulated replacement window. Their windows are guaranteed to save you up to 40% on your cooling bills this summer. Thermal King has over 40 years of experience in installing windows, doors, and siding in the greater Kansas City metro area. FC Kansas City fans, join your favorite players and coaches immediately following each and every home game right up the street at the Grand Falloon off of Ward Parkway at the Country Club Plaza. Their spacious interior, beautiful outdoor patio, and award-winning food make the Grand Falloon the perfect post-game headquarters. The brand new 816 Hotel is the official hotel of FC Kansas City. Stay where the visiting NWSL teams stay when they come to town, located right in the heart of Westport. The 816 Hotel features unique rooms showcasing many of Kansas City's most famous companies and landmarks. For more information, visit 816hotel.com. RG Federal Credit Union is the official credit union of FC Kansas City. The more you save, the more you earn. Get started on your RG Federal Credit Union Smart Saver plan by visiting rgfcu.com. Paul Mitchell, the school, is the official hair salon of FC Kansas City. Get your hair cut and styled where the blues do at Paul Mitchell, the school, located at 95th and Antioch in Overland Park. The National Guard is proud to be the official Armed Forces partner with FC Kansas City. Be on the lookout for our free grassroots soccer clinics in your area. Visit guardsoccer.com to find out how eligible high school age players, their parents, and coaches can learn of the many benefits offered by the Guard, including tuition assistance. The Preserve at Overland Park is the official apartment homes of FC Kansas City. Live where the blues live in beautiful South Johnson County. Conveniently located off 119th and Quivira, the Preserve at Overland Park is an amazing place to call home. Ladies and gentlemen, FC Kansas City and our partners at GSI Travel are proud to recognize local youth soccer teams from both sides of the state line. We like to honor teams who display team pride, sportsmanship, community involvement, and a passion for the game, along with their on-field successes. This week's Team of the Week is KC Blaze Galaxy. These young ladies are the Kansas U-12 Junior State Cup champions, coached by Jeff Van Dusen. Congratulations to KC Blaze Galaxy. If you know of a team that deserves recognition, check out fckansascity.com/Team of the Week and send in your nomination. And now here are halftime game statistics. At halftime, we have no score. Total shots, FCKC 7, Chicago 3. 4 FC Kansas City shots on goal to 2 for Chicago. 2 saves for FC Kansas City, 4 for the Red Stars. FC Kansas City has taken 3 corner kicks to none for Chicago. No fouls for the Blues, 5 for the Red Stars, and neither team has accrued a caution or red card as of halftime. FC Kansas City would like to thank the following groups for coming out today. The U13 Girls LSSA Riptide Fury, KC Metro League Champions, the Gattermeyer Family, St. Thomas, and our happy birthday this evening is to Nancy Stell, and according to her son Brad, she is only 39 years old today. That's amazing. Happy birthday, Nancy. Tonight's Ball Kids are sponsored by Freestyle Graphics. NWSL final score tonight, Portland 6, Washington 1.
Hush, don't speak when you spit your venom, keep it shut. I hate it when you hiss and preach about your new messiah, cause your theories catch fire. I can't find your silver lining.
Also a final score this evening from World Cup action. Nigeria 1, Bosnia-Herzegovina 0.
Let's go.
rather be a coward when our worlds collide. Gonna drown you out before I lose my mind. I can't find your silver lining. I don't mean to judge, but when you read your speech, it's tiring. Enough is enough. I'm covering my ears like a kid. Will your words be nothing? I go la la la. I'm turning.
Come on,
baby, you a song. You make me wanna roll my windows down and cruise.
I got my windows down. talking, and you didn't think that I would hear it. People hear you talking like that, getting everybody fired up. So I'm ready to attack, gonna lead the fight, gonna get a touchdown, gonna take you out. That's right, put your pom-poms down, getting everybody fired up.
Very fit player, and you know, she can bring that energy for a full 90 minutes, and you know, you're not going to see her fatigue, and that's a, you know, she's the engine of this of Kansas City team, and you know, she'll just be pushing them, and I'm pretty confident that they're going, you know, they're going to get something in the next 15 minutes.
Portland was able to get an impressive win tonight over Washington, 6-1 the final. Alex Morgan, who scored twice for the national team against France in the friendly at the end of the week. Two goals in this one. Jessica McDonald with two more. Allie Long, Christina Sinclair scoring as well. And it's so good for the national team to see Morgan not only available, but playing at that level.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, she's come straight back into form. And, you know, obviously the World Cup coming up next year, she just wants to keep that form going and be playing regularly and scoring goals. And, you know, it's going to be big, big for the U.S. national team.
Well, Becky Sauerbrunn, Lauren Holiday, both demanding, begging to be in the starting lineup after it's been a grueling couple of weeks for those two players on national team duty. They will begin the second half on the field, and that sounds about right for a scoreless game when you need 3 points at home.
Absolutely.
Don't see any substitutions for either team to begin the final 45 minutes. There's Becky Sauerbrunn, who's been the captain for the national team and FC Kansas City as well. Flags are limp, so Breeze will not be any assistance at all on a night where it was 90 degrees at the start of the match. Finally a whistle. And FC Kansas City will take it off the free kick. Nikki Phillips to Jen Buskowski.
Hope that doesn't do something.
Leanne Robinson with great value, able to attack from her right back position. Come all the way forward. Matthias Herod doesn't get a good foot on it. Simrak tries to run it down outside of the edge of the 18. And Buskowski has Coleman, but plays it back to Richmond. Taken by Chicago, Leon. Rodriguez waits for Holiday. Cassie Coleman in the middle. The block hasn't come loose for just an eyelash, just a moment of time there.
I think Matthias thought she was in there for a second. Ball just slipping out of the goalkeeper's hands. Managed to get it back under control.
Merritt Matthias, was nothing wrong with being a poacher.
Absolutely.
Getting a free goal.
Had the best ones.
Maybe one of the goals that's hard to shake mentally when you give one up. Lauren Holiday with an elbow getting tangled up, and there will maybe be a bit of a talking to with Emily Van Egmond. We've seen that a couple of times in this, and consistent with the scrappy nature of this Red Star team. Not seen a card in this one yet. Ball sent through the touchline. Throw in FCKC. Leanne Robinson will handle it.
Could be some coming out soon. It's getting very physical in the middle. Great battle going on there.
So how do you use that to your advantage?
You know, obviously Kansas City are going to get some free kicks in good positions. You know, Holiday's just got to keep shielding the ball and it, you know, release pressure. And Kansas City needs to, you know, take some quick free kicks and try and catch Chicago on the counter.
Now, Katrina Gorey, one of the bodies available for FCKC just getting here a week ago from Australia, able to get up to speed in a very quick amount of time, playing underneath the forward in Holiday spot, getting a start at Houston. She doesn't train with any kind of a wrap on her leg or knee, but she likes to play with her right knee wrap. It's kind of a confidence thing. She just likes the feel of having that support.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think they train on grass too, and maybe it's the turf that she likes to have it taped up with.
Long taking her time. Rodriguez comes up to force the issue. Merritt Mathias gets loose. Double team. Mathias goes down. LeBlanc is there. Mathias slow to get up. Staggers back to her feet.
It's a great play from Mathias there. Being tough, driving through. Maybe she can get her body in the way. She goes down there. Could have got a chance for a PK. Very good defender from Chicago.
Julie Johnston there. And a double team. Mathias again. Seems to be playing a little bit higher than we normally see her out of her right mid spot.
She's getting in some good spots, and she's feeling it right now. And Kansas City, having a good little spell. Need to keep this going.
Blocked out by Leanne Robinson. Goal kick, Chicago. 50th minute of play. FCKC in a stretch where they've gone 4-0-2 in their last six, winning four consecutive, 7-1. Seven goals scored, only one allowed over the past four. The biggest difference now is less fatigue, less travel. They're not playing twice a week, while the rest of the league, that's what they're getting now. What FCKC had, they were just dog tired. Now the schedule has favored them. They do have a rough stretch toward the end of the year, which is why they want to make hay now when they can.
Absolutely. It's always tough, you know, trying to keep all the girls healthy and with a tough schedule and a lot of games.
Sauerbrunn has helped to her left. Nikki Phillips broke her nose in the first game of the year. Tim Rack. Rod plays it to Coleman. It's pushed by Van Egmond. Sauerbrunn, who was still out there, going strong after playing 90 minutes in the U.S. friendly against France, a 2-2 final. Alex Morgan scoring twice. Hope Solo not playing. That's a whole nother show right there. I'll tell you, when Seattle was here, I think Hope Solo signed every autograph. The girls are great about staying afterwards. And once it's done, all the kids go down to the fence, and players have been great about that so far. We've seen that in the 2 years of this league, how fan-friendly they are.
I think that's why it brings more fans out to the games. Great connection.
Julie Johnston with fresh from Buzkowski. Switching the field now. Back in the middle, that's Leon. Not many options inside. Headed toward Barnhart and handled. FCKC will give it back. Van Egmond was there for Chicago, now played back the keeper. Is this good for Chicago's confidence, the deeper we go in to be even?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you know, you can see them time wasting a little bit, and, you know, the goalkeeper's holding onto the ball. They want to, you know, they'll take this result. You know, Kansas City needs to step up a bit higher and push the game and try and get themselves a goal.
Attack with 11, defend with 11.
Absolutely. Sooner than later.
Chicago throw in, Keisha Moreway. Oh, Allman tries to run it down. That's Tim Rack. I get back to the rookie. I had a lot of faith in Cassie Coleman to give her so much action, even though she was a first-round draft pick as a rookie. That's a lot to throw somebody in. And, you know, you play center back in college. Now I'm going to ask you to play left back, and it's not the same.
I think she's settled into that position fantastically. You know, it's a sign of a good player. The more positions you can play, the more valuable are to your coach.
Tim Rack. Takes a tumble, goes down with Kwan. Now two more go down. Coleman, Van Eggman as well. Things getting a little bit chippy. And the heat might have something to do with that.
Absolutely. People starting to get tired. You know, there'll be mistakes, and the game's going to open up a little bit. You know, if a Kansas City can get a goal now, then, you know, the next, before the 60th minute, it'll be a different game.
Julie Johnston will handle the free kick. Headed forward. Blue shirts everywhere, taken away. Jenna Richmond.
Great defending there from Kansas City. Relieving the pressure. Swarming the Chicago player as soon as they get the ball.
Richmond, part of the UCLA National Championship last year. And she has far exceeded their expectations. She's been terrific.
I think she'll continue to. Very, very talented player and very intelligent player, too.
You know, when you think about a sweeper, it's like, okay, we need you at the other end, too. You're not just defending.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, both sides of the ball. And, you know, it's their job to keep the ball moving and switching the play and boss the midfield. And she's, you know, she's doing a fantastic.
Zarbin plays it to her right, Leanne Robinson. And ahead, Eric Mathias. The middle, Lauren Holiday, ball in front. Runs on it. Oh, comes out for Chicago. And Credi. At Stanford. And a first team All American. Really good college player. Long coming off time with the Canadian Nationals.
Dre, I would stay inside a bit still. Stay inside.
56th minute. Game 15 for FC Kansas City, 24-game regular season. Top four teams make the postseason. It's all about getting to that semifinal round. Nicole Barnhart well out the penalty area. Dan Credi trying to slide it through. Get it to press. Eric Mathias with some space defending his sitch. Now Lauren Holiday. A lot of white shirts packed in from the edge of the 18 and within about 10 yards of that line. So where do you attack them, Dawn? Where do you look at any kind of a spot that's vulnerable when they're packing in the bodies in the middle of the field like that?
Yeah, I think when they keep getting the ball wide, you know, they're getting a bit of joy and crosses in the box, and, you know, just there, they win the corner. And, you know, I think the key right now is to get outside and get balls in the box and get numbers in the box and, you know, win the ball and want it more and get some shots on target.
Holiday, another corner, her fourth. Chicago has yet to take one. Mathias and Rodriguez inside of the six. Holiday plays a line drive, headed. And another corner on the other side.
Great ball in the box there from Holiday. Great driven corner. You see driving it in the box there. Pinging off, I think this may be the goalkeeper too, or the defender, I'm not sure.
Yeah, LeBlanc might have been the one who deflected that. out and setting up a corner on the other side.
Great ball in the box, causing chaos there.
Holiday will try it again. Same two bodies in the six. Finds side netting. Goal kick, Chicago.
Yeah, it's tough there. Bit of a wasted corner. You want to get that one in the box. You know, last one was a fantastic corner. This one, she just doesn't strike it as well.
How many different types of corners will teams work on? Is there one that they favor primarily, or do you want to keep the other team guessing?
I guess it depends what kind of players you have. And obviously, you want to keep them guessing and change it up. You know, some players like to shoot, some players whip it, float it. You know, I like the way Zusi take corners, and I'm sure everyone else in the country does right now.
Dom Dwyer from Sporting Kansas City is our analyst here tonight. Major League Soccer's Player of the Month for May. 6 goals in the month, 11 so far this year. You ever sit back and do the calculations, what you're going to end up with or what you want to, or you just let them happen and then you'll count them later?
Yeah, I set targets at the start of the year, but, you know, obviously I just want to win games, and, you know, if the goals come with it, then that's good, but I just want to win again. It's the best feeling.
Ann Robinson sends it behind the goal. Well, you'll be better as a team when you get those two guys back from Brazil, but no hurry. They can stay as long as they need to.
Absolutely. It'll be great to see them go far. And, you know, I know I've spoke to them both, and I'm sure they're very much enjoying it.
Of course, Beasler coming out after a little bit of a grab in his hamstring, but expected to be just fine for game two against Portugal.
Yeah, I think it was a smart decision to take him out at halftime. You know, obviously seeing Josie go down early on in the game, you know, it was a tough loss for the U.S., but, you know, it's good to see that Beas is still okay and his World Cup's still going strong.
Kwan's long ball goes back Kansas City's way. Now Winino there. Play it wide. Now back to the keeper. As Rodriguez will apply some pressure. Richmond tried to head it a second time. Now comes out of there with it. Erica Timrak. Middle, Kwan sticking a foot in. Chicago coming up big defensively. Chicago might not hate getting out of here with a point.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm sure they'll be very happy with a point, and they're you know, defending tough right now and blocking out the middle, giving Kansas City no chance to go through the middle and need to start getting the ball wide and trying to get crosses in or trying something different.
Matt Aikman able to stick a foot in there and get it in front of Holiday. Chicago ball. Sitch can't get there. Becky Sauerbrunn, center back, coming all the way forward and making a diagonal run, now stopping outside of the 18. We've seen Nicole Phillips score a goal this year from her position in back. There's no law against it.
It does happen. It is possible.
It's possible, and it can be a good thing.
Yes.
Ball gets past press. Phillips reorganizes. Now Richmond plays it back to Barney. A little bit surprising that Ashlyn Harris was the choice when Hope Solo was not available for the second friendly, but Barnhart was happy with the way training went with the national team. Laskowski. Robinson to the right.
No service! Thanks!
Moreway defending. And Rodriguez will run it down and turn it the other way. 62nd minute. And not a problem. LeBlanc there to take it.
Yeah, Rodriguez does a great job sprinting out to get that ball back. Tries to put it in the box. No one's there. She's normally that person in the box there, I guess.
We have not seen a substitution from either team yet. Chicago could do that as a way to eat some time later if they choose.
Absolutely. Maybe Kansas City freshen up some legs and sharpen things up a bit, get themselves a goal.
Vanessa DiBernardo, we saw a lot of her when they played early in the season. but not in tonight's starting lineup. Of course, her father played for the Kansas City Comets, Angelo, back in the day. She was a first-round draft pick of the Red Stars. Now, Holiday can do that to you. He's broken a few ankles. Ann Robinson makes a run at the edge. Block goes horizontal to get it. And Matthias in front, but it went all the way through to the keeper.
It's great confident goalkeeping there. Reading, seeing the ball is going to come through to near post. This comes out. Erod made a great run across the front.
Leon on a run, bumped out by Cassie Coleman. And we talked about Katrina Gorey from Australia, who had a big role in the game at Houston, able to get a start in having less than a full week with the team, but they needed her, and Lauren Holiday will make her exit here in the 64th minute. So after playing 290s for the national team, captain will check out.
Done a fantastic job tonight, Holiday. Giving those legs a little bit of a rest, I think, had a few hard games, like you said.
Ladies and gentlemen, time to take Lori came from Australia. She's not 5 feet tall. And they call her Minnie. And when she got here, she was desperate for transportation, put it out on Twitter that she needed a car, and somebody responded, said, give me your phone number, and she was reluctant initially that, you know, who am I gonna give my number to? And there's a nice family in town that had two cars, and they said she could pick the one she wanted, and she selected the Mini Cooper.
Oh, wow.
So Minnie is driving a Mini.
I love it.
Yes. Gorey, finding that nice people here in Kansas City, you probably had the same experience. Maybe not people giving you cars, but just the hospitality here in the Midwest.
Yeah, no cars, but no, definitely some great hospitality, and you know, meet some very great and generous people. It's a nice city, and you know, obviously it's a fantastic one to play in.
Tim Rag is possessed, back to Coleman. Kwan marking, and the ball will roll through, throw in for Chicago. Corey didn't play a full 90 at Houston, but had a good turn before Mandy Laddish from Lee Summit, and Notre Dame spelled her the last 15 minutes. Some challenges about a 4-9 player, but tactically very sound, good work rate, and she has a big foot. She again wraps that right knee just for the comfort of the mental whatever goes with that, knowing that her knee and leg are secure. Attendance 1493 here tonight, which is a bit about the average. When Seattle was here, the number was much bigger in the opener as well. Seeing the attendance down a bit across the board in the league, which happens a little bit in sophomore season, the second go around, but I think the caliber of play has been up, though. When you talk about national teams stocking the talent, we're looking at a bunch of world-class players out here.
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, just women's soccer in this country is huge, and you know, obviously you see the women's team are very elite in the world stage.
67th minute, and speaking of DiBernardo, Vanessa will check in. Vanessa starting 12 games for Chicago this year. She'll come off the bench for the first time. DiBernardo has contributed a goal and three assists on this season, but first time subbing in. And Melissa Tancredi will check out. Her night is done in the 68th minute, getting her first start. Hadn't been here long. Has school responsibilities. Her Dr. Melissa Palma Julie Tancredi is coming in a matter of weeks, finishing up chiropractic school in St. Louis, in Chesterfield. Long attempt will sail past Nicole Barnhart. how do you fight through it when it's the 68th minute and you've been out there sweating and running and you're tired and you know that somebody needs to score, but you also know you can't let down for a second because you don't want the other team to score.
Yeah, absolutely.
Ball's loose and struck well that time. Christian Press.
Yeah, you know, obviously it's a vital time of the game now. Last 20 minutes, you know, Kansas City needs to press hard right now. They need to get it. You know, they'll be getting their second win right now. They wouldn't really feel tired anymore. It'll be the, you know, the adrenaline will be going and they're going to, you know, really push forward and hopefully attack. And it'll be a very entertaining last 20 minutes.
Well, Press would like to put her team in a position to get a goal here down the stretch. A terrific player, just 23. Saw her play 90 and 90 in those two U.S. friendlies. Playing with Tereso in Sweden. First American ever to get the golden boot there, scoring 23 goals in a season.
Is pink ticket 227683. Pink ticket 227683. Please head to the Firestone tent at the front entrance.
Julie Johnston will put it back in play on a hot, sweaty night here. It's the only bad thing about the turf when you go home, you got about 8 pounds of little rubber chewed up pieces in your shoes. Sauerbrunn now Phillips. Taken away Sauerbrunn. Julianne Sitch was there for Chicago. Robinson with pressure by DiBernardo. Each team using one sub so far here in the second half. Liz Bogus is talking with Vladko Andonovsky. Appears to be the next sub to come in for FCKC. She's dealt with some injury issues and watching her training the last couple of weeks run slowly, run faster, and getting close to a full turn this week. Maybe not 100%, but cleared to play.
Be good to get her in, fresh legs, you know, get her going to the defense and you know, helping create a goal. She's a very talented player and you know, perfect time right now to get her on the field and get her involved.
Well, at the beginning of the season when the Blues played two up top, it was Rodriguez and Bogus. And we saw her play wide right and out of the spot that Merritt Mathias has taken. We've also seen Bogus in different spots all over the field. Ball loose, Erica Timrak has A-Rod to her left. Step over, back to Rodriguez, left-footed shot, side netting. What a good spot for the lefty, tough angle, but we've seen her do crazier things from there.
There's good defending from Chicago there. Timrak driving to the defense, you know, trying to wait until the defender commits. It's good defending, staying on their feet well, closing down the angle. A-Rod has no angle there.
As Bogus will check in, Erica Timrak comes out in the 72nd minute.
She had a good night tonight. Very good game, well played, good positive play, attacking players and causing trouble. Very, very solid game for her.
She's good making that run from the edge of the 18 there in the corner.
She's gonna do that a few times this year.
Red Stars playing it out of the back, 72nd minute, still scoreless. FC Kansas City 7-0-3 when scoring first. Chicago's number also impressive at 5-1-1, but we need a goal. Haven't been able to get one from either. There's Gorey.
Kansas City pressing hard, pressing well, just having a little bit of trouble trying to break down that Chicago defense right now. Need to keep pushing on forwards here.
Amanda, next up.
Pressure on Leanne Robinson by Sitch. All available in the middle. Leon. Robinson. We switch the field now all the way to Cassie Coleman. Chicago coming off a shutout looking for a goal here tonight. Ball in play. Leon plays it ahead to Press. We'll have to circle back. And punched out Nikki Phillips. Good hustle. by the FCKC defense. And another substitution is for Chicago. Karen Hemmings will. And Rachel Kwansnight is done. Now in the 74th minute. In Chicago, Hemmings, who just came in. Double team pressure, Leon. Had to get away from traffic.
Great feed there in the corner.
Hemmings again, throw in. In the middle, headed out by Sauerbrunn. And a long boot by Julie Johnston. Not close to anything, but the bleachers behind.
Yeah, it's missed better play there from Chicago. Leon's giving them a little bit of trouble and putting a good balls in the box. But Kansas City looking very comfortable, and need to keep attacking the goal here and get some chances.
Bogus through traffic. This with fresh legs, not just tonight, but for a while. Certainly frustrated by some of the limitations due to injuries. One of the players they really wanted to be able to fill the gaps when national team players were called away. But there are worse times, but available and playing here tonight. Other options off the bench for the Blues: Franz Silva, Morgan Marlborough. Offensive threats, both of them. Marlborough, one of the players, and I'm sure that they're or guys that you've played with that in training score a million goals. You just know that they're going to score every time they touch it.
Yep.
And that's been Morgan so far.
Yeah, we've seen him. And, you see them hitting the back of the net, you want to give them the ball. And, that's the kind of player that, like you said, that she's wanting to be. And that's the kind of player you want on your team.
It's Bogus with a big bump. Nothing there. They play on. And a throw in Chicago. Leon was there, but Hemmings will step back to take it. Bogus headed, now a collision. Kolupny, the captain. Bogus may have been waiting to give someone that. Leanne Robinson striding in space. To slide it through, Merritt Mathias. Cross, shot, and a goal! Why not a defender? Jen Buzkowski scoring for the first time this year in the 76th minute, and FCKC has grabbed the lead.
Tell you what, that is a fantastic cross from Merritt there, and a fantastic run from Buzkowski coming in on the back post. A very difficult finish there. Great run there from Leanne Robinson. Great ball from Merritt Mathias. And there she is, Buzkowski there, sneaking in that back corner. Fantastic finish, 1-0.
And LeBlanc tried to close the window down, but there was enough of it for Buzkowski to score. Shot will go behind the goal. And, Buzz had played every minute in franchise history till the last home game. She came out 10, 15 minutes to go and asked her about it at training. She goes, sometimes it's you just have to get off the field. it's good for you, maybe mentally, physically, to get that break.
Absolutely. You see it from a different angle as well.
And Jen Hoy, who we thought might be part of a three-forward starting lineup, but didn't. We'll check in now in the 78th minute with Chicago playing from behind. Red Stars down a goal.
On the field for Chicago Red Stars.
Adriana Leon will come out of play here in the 78th minute.
Hoy, replacing number 19, Adriana Leon.
Hoy was star at Princeton, played for the under-23s. Four goals this year, leads Chicago, and they are in need now. And Buzkowski just performed at the other end, playing defense as well.
She's all over the place today, fantastic. You know, she's doing a great job getting on the ball, opening up, switching the play. You know, she's that one that is opening the game up and just keeps the team open and, you know, Chicago having to chase the game.
Now you wonder if there's a substitution for FC Kansas City, if it would be defensive-minded with the lead?
Yeah, I think you wait a couple of minutes now and see how the next 5 minute goes and then make a decision from there, but definitely another little change and, you know, waste a bit more time.
Sitch able to turn it after the A-Rod giveaway. Hang it on the boundary, Hemmings down in the middle. Kolupny, captain goes down, Trina Gorey.
Great tackle there.
Rodriguez back to Phillips. Richmond. Becky Sauerbrunn, who is still out there. In a 1-0 game, the captain, the center back, she ain't coming out, is she? There's no chance.
Nah, she ain't coming out. She's ready. She played 80 minutes. You know, she'll finish off her last 10, or she'll definitely want to. So we'll see.
She talked on her blog about how intense the last couple of weeks has been. You know, what day is it? Who am I? When you're just fully involved in all of the soccer. It's bogus. A nice cross. LeBlanc able to step off her line and grab that, really. No one there nearby. Rodriguez might have been the closest to it. Well struck. I think for the most part, all the girls would agree, as tired as they are, they're playing a game they love to make a living. And nothing wrong with that.
Absolutely. It's, you have to think about it sometimes and, you know, remember to enjoy it and remember why you do it and why you're playing it. You know, it's definitely the mental mindset. You know, you have to not make it a job and make it, you know, try and make it a hobby and have fun. And, you know, you see those girls out there smiling and having fun playing, you know, they'll be the best players.
So what radars are you on back home now after the season you've had so far?
I have no idea. You know, obviously lots of people talk and you hear all sorts of rumors and stuff like that. But, you know, I just concentrate on the season right now with Kansas City and obviously enjoying it and got to keep scoring goals and we need to keep winning games. And, you know, we're starting to come back into form after a tough little run.
Robinson will let up with pressure by Jen Hoy. Skowski plays it back. Becky Sauerbrunn switching the field. Cassie Coleman. Jen Hoy, the latest sub to come in for Chicago, their leading goal scorer with four so far this season, two game winners. She's assisted on a couple. Good player in this league. Rodriguez has really not had any time to speak of with Gorey on the practice field. Sarah Hagen will get involved next week.
But now we can get out of it. Come on, Jen! Kristen, you gotta make some
room. Johnston has space on the right, has Hemmings in front. Sends it back toward the middle. Bogus, now Richmond. And Merritt Mathias in space in the middle in the 82nd minute. FCKC by a goal after Buskowski delivered in the 76th minute. Beautiful cross set up by Merritt Mathias, who received it from Leanne Robinson. Back to Barnhart, who leads the league with five shutouts. Going for number six. And a trip. And a card. So you saw that coming. Emily Van Eggman.
Great little spell there from Kansas City. Keeping the ball. You know, waiting about a minute of time. Great touch here. She just nicks it before her. Just takes her out. Definitely a yellow. First one of the game. Could get exciting.
Now they had four last time against Western New York midweek. Without a bit of a frustration.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's about time in the game now where the frustration kicks in. Chicago.
Physical player, smart, and the right call here for the third substitution with 4 minutes left in regulation, and FCKC up by a goal.
Yeah, absolutely. Kansas City, you just want to keep it tight now, try and close out this game. Try and be patient on the counterattack when they win the ball back and just keep the ball.
Now press, can't control it in the penalty area. Nicky Phillips, all knocked back off of Holman. And they will stop for the substitution. LaPel that will check in.
Substitution the 87th on the field for Kansas City.
Jenna Richmond.
Number 17, Ingrid Pelbert, replacing number 7, Jenna Richmond.
Slowly heads for the middle of the field. Ingrid Pelbert, very well respected in the community when she finally returned the last home game. A terrific ovation from the crowd that understood the history, maybe not all of the challenges that go through a serious injury like an ACL. You ever had anything like that you had to battle back from?
Yeah, I've had a pretty bad broken foot, which I broke 3 times in a row coming back. So, you know, I was told at 18 that it was over for me. So that was kind of when I came to America to play college, and you never know. And obviously it's great to see players back on the field after a big setback.
Well, I'd say the doctor was wrong on that one.
Yeah, I think so. I think you got that one wrong. I'm a bit stubborn.
Stubborn's good. Modern medicine is good. Doing all your rehab is good. Working hard.
Yep.
There's 2 minutes left here in regulation. FCKC trying to get that win streak to 5. Lead by Kansas City to the middle. Norway was in back there. DiBernardo. Laskowski backs off. They play it to Jen Hoy right side. Double teamed. And Coleman is taken down. And a goal kick. Nicole Barnhart, who will be in no hurry to put this thing in flight. The 89th minute now.
Great defending there from Kalman. Just getting her body in the way. She'll now play. Get Kansas City a goal kick. Last minute of the game. Just got to waste time now and keep the ball.
Tony Miola was as good as anybody when it came to just wasting time in a situation like this. Make him count.
Yeah, absolutely. You can waste a good 30 seconds on a goal kick. Maybe that instance you were talking about earlier, taking the yellow card. You know, you never know. Goalkeepers wasting more time.
Less than a minute here. We'll wait on stoppage time. There could be a minute or two, not much. Press tries to flip it over to herself. Now Sauerbrunn can't clear it. It'll be a goal kick. Nicole Barnhart. Becky Sauerbrunn, who insisted that she start tonight, despite her travel schedule, work schedule with the national team. Lauren Holiday, same position, close to getting a result here, but it ain't over yet. Chicago has dangerous scores on the field. Play in the box. See Casey. 4, 5, 6 blue jerseys inside the penalty area. Setting up now for a corner kick with 1 minute left. Out in front of the six, headed just to the wide side of the goal. Michelle Winona was there. Boy, pretty well struck, but just off target. See the clock running there to the side, the stoppage time. Hemmings. And on is Bogus, able to get away. And Bogus again will create the pressure, and Chicago hurries to get another corner kick. They will allow that to happen.
Last seconds here, everyone coming up, even the goalkeeper.
Becky Sauerbrunn directing traffic inside of the six-yard box, barking instruction. The ball, far post, Nicole Barnhart goes up to grab it, and with it, season shutout number six, and FC Casey gets the win streak to five, keeping the pressure on Seattle, if there is such a thing. Able to win for the eighth time this year, 27 points, and creating a little bit of cushion between second and third place. And we have a player down. We have one of the medical staff members for Chicago headed out that way. FCKC staff as well out there. And it can just be crazy there on a corner, right, just with all the bodies inside of the box. And
yeah, I think
especially
she's okay
at that point of the game.
Yeah, she just smashed into Barna there. She's a big girl.
The referee has blown the whistle. This match has come to an end.
Well, Nicole Barnhart has learned that you can have no fear, especially at this time, going up high. And a big collision there with Michelle Winano, who went down and was just now up to her feet for the first time. FCKC is able to extend their win streak to five. And they get a bit of a break again, not playing until next Saturday when Portland plays here. So I'm going to give you a high mark for your first television analyst work. How'd it go?
Did okay? I don't know. It was all right. A bit slow start, but it's definitely fun, and I look forward to doing it again.
What about FCKC, the performance you saw here tonight? What do you take away from the way they were able to finish late with Buskowski getting a game-winning goal in the 76th minute?
Yeah, it wasn't a convincing 3-4-0 game.